folks. It's Tuesday, which for me is fly day. I am flying to Toronto in a couple hours. I totally meant to take some videos earlier, but unfortunately I was really busy just running around. I did some last minute packing, finished up some dishes and laundry that were in the house just so I wouldn't have to deal with that when I came back. I took the dogs for a walk, dropped them off at their respective babysitters, and now I'm here. I never understand why people always line up so early.
They haven't even called a zone to board yet.
Why would you want to be on the plane that long? Because I don't. I want to be the last person on there. But also, why don't they load planes, everybody that's on the window seat, everybody that's on the middle seat, and then everybody that's on the aisle seat? That would save everybody so much trouble not having to fight to get over each other. And I'm settled in. I'm a little anxious, but I'm on Discord with Caitlin, so that makes me a little less anxious, which is nice. I did not realize how much I don't like being alone or traveling alone until right now. So hopefully I can get the heck over it because I'm here all week alone. So wish me luck. Good morning, everyone. It is Wednesday. It's Wednesday.
It's Wednesday, dudes.
And it's my first full day in Toronto. Don't mind my hair right now. I literally just got out of bed. I'm about to get ready and go down to the fitness center, get a little hot girl walk-in. Then I'll probably have a little bit of breakfast. And then I have to go pick up my headshots from a local print shop because my stupid self forgot to print them before I came here. I was so focused on the singing competition and the acting competition that I completely forgot about my photo go-see and that I needed to print off. They're being printed today. I'm gonna pick those up around lunchtime. We'll be okay. I guess I might as well expose myself to you guys. I'm really dumb and forgot my anxiety medication at home. So now it's being FedExed up to me by my mom. Hate myself. Shit happens. I was literally sat in the St. John's Airport. I was on Discord with Caitlin. I looked at my phone and I got a notification reminding me to take my medication. And everything in me just sank because I knew that I did not have them. I've never felt more stupid. I've never wanted to cry so fast in my life. Anyways, I managed to bring everything else that I need, I think. Keep you updated because at this point, who knows? Hot girl walk-in. Except for I don't look very hot girl right now. I will absolutely be getting in here at some point this week. I will be in you. As you can see, I have completed my workout. Did my weights and then I got on the treadmill again after and did a vocal warm-up and sang my song twice while on the treadmill. So be proud of me. Got a little bit of room service. It doesn't look that good, but I'm hoping it'll taste better than it looks. ordered myself some food, and it's probably gonna end up being my lunch and my supper because it's a lot more than I imagined. This shit's heavy, actually. Fried rice with shrimp, and I have a spring roll with it, but the spring roll is like smoky. And I have this dummy.
I have this one.
Cutie. Yeah. I just took a little nap and I woke up to get ready and look at this. Very pretty, but I do have to walk over to the conference, so sick.
Makeup is done. Fit has been checked. Let's get this shit.
I can still see the planes. Cool. I'm almost here. There's a lot of people coming out with numbers on their chest, which means that I'm gonna get a big fat number on my chest. I know that this is where finals and some of the big parties take place, but I believe I'm headed that way. It chose my hip instead of my chest. I'm number 611. I also bought a baseball t-shirt because I couldn't possibly see merch and not purchase it. But I still have another hour before I need to go to singing preliminaries. So I don't know. I think I'm just gonna sit around in this hotel and see who's coming and going. Which might be like really nosy and creepy, but like, I don't wanna go back to my room. So, ooh, that shit gotta be blended. Catch up with you in a bit. Okay, I'm done my singing preliminaries. I think I did okay. It's raining really hard right now. Oh God. I think I did okay. They didn't cut me off, but they were cutting people off. So that makes me feel like I did all right. And one of the judges was actually Farley Flex from Canadian Idol. And it was a little intimidating, but I just kept, you know, making eye contact with everybody as much as I could, trying to sing to their souls. Despite my voice being a little shaky the whole time, just because of nerves, I think it was good. We'll find out tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. I think. I also made a couple friends that I had to stand in line with. We're like lined up by numbers. The two girls that are in front of me are very nice. Their names are Jen and Jin, so very easy to remember. But I'm very happy to have made some friends because now I've got someone to be with this whole week. They're in the same competitions that I'm in, so we'll be in line together every single time we line up for a competition, which is great. I hope you guys can see how much it's raining right now because I'm getting soaked, but I don't even care because singing prelims are over and now I can just relax and try to turn my brain off. She took her concerta today, boys. And yesterday, I edited an entire vlog yesterday and today, and now I'm going to yoga with Brooklyn and Jessica. Brooklyn tried. She was close, but she was not in front of my house.
Miss Givick, huh?
You've got a big job today in replacing Rebecca.
Both of you.
Oh.
You have to be extra loud.
Okay.
Brooklyn came in from this way, and I said, Rebecca would be very angry at you. She would look at you like, but she's nice like that, so she would back up for you and let you go, but she would yell fucking profanities at you.
Facts.
Do you hear that, Brooklyn? Rebecca would not be happy at all. Mwah!
I just said I did yoga. I told you no.
I like that one.
Jessica, it's 12 on its own, 2 for 20.
This is my headband.
Thank you, Jess. It's day 2 of CMTC. Today is orientation and seminars and stuff. I don't think I have any of my competitions today. I think they're both tomorrow, actually. So I'm probably just gonna like creep around and watch. Medication is supposed to get shipped to me today. And I think I also will be able to pick up my prints from Staples today. So I'm about to just brush my teeth, get ready, and head over to orientation. I also just DoorDashed 4 Monsters for $30 because I'm sick in the head and there is literally not one convenience store that's in a distance that I will walk. Like the closest convenience store is way over there. So like I would have to walk all the way down here, all the way down here and go under that overpass and it's past the overpass. Or there's another one like way further down that way too. I can't get to either of those places before I go to orientation and orientation is right there. So $30 for 4 Monsters it is. I can't survive without them. I'm sorry to my mom if she sees this. Not the color I ordered, but whatever. Number is on. Fit checked. We are headed to orientation / day 2. Again, need to blend the jaw contour. What else is new?
And scene work and improv and all this really cool stuff. But at the end of the day, it's your humanity. It's who you are at your core and how you came into this world and what you want to give voice to that's really going to matter and really going to put you over the edge.
Just took an Uber to Staples, got my prints. They're very big, hopefully that's okay. I noticed that there's a Winners here. So you bet your bottom dollar that I'm gonna go into that Winners and see what they have there. I believe there's a man cat calling me right now. I'm gonna ignore him so I don't fucking get kidnapped. Please and thank you. But I am gonna go in this Winners and see what they got before I go back to the hotel. So Winners was a little bit of a bust. They didn't really have anything all that nice. I just don't think it's the right area to be looking for that type of stuff. So anyways, I Ubered back to my hotel and ordered some food. And I'm just going to chill out here now for a good few hours. We have the pink party tonight. They did post the singing finalists. I was not one of them. That is quite okay though, because there was literally hundreds of us that did preliminaries. And they only chose 5 girls and 5 boys from my division. So we'll take it. It's okay. I'm just glad that I did it. Honestly, I'm glad that I sang in front of people that matter a little bit more, maybe, I guess. I don't know. I'm sure I'll have plenty of other opportunities again. And, you know, at least they saw me. At least they heard me. They know I exist. Tomorrow, I'm skipping the contour because this is really getting on my nerves. It doesn't look like this when I leave. And then, so no contour for me tomorrow. I ordered Popeyes and I'm stoked about it. If I'm being completely honest, I actually ordered Popeyes Tuesday night as well, but I think I accidentally ordered spicy or they gave me spicy, even though it's not what I ordered. So hopefully this time's better. Hi friends, Hattie. I have not done much of anything today, but go to the store and get myself some chippies.
Editing the vlog that you're watching right now. Rebecca called me earlier and asked me to call a sus number that called her, so I harassed that number for a little bit. Me and Jess are going to the Sci-Fi Farmers Market right now because we have nothing to do, so figured content. Yeah, we went to a farmers market yesterday. Yeah, we're going to one today. Yeah, we're gonna go to one Saturday. There you go. Now we'll go feed her. She's a psycho. What? You're not hungry.
No.
I'm glad somebody gets to eat supper today, because I sure ain't.
Jessica's here. We got my 1975 sweater. We got my rings. And my little she-they pin.
Farmer's market is 5 to 9. We show up at 8:20.
That's all the time we need. Let's go. Remember you made me throw mine out?
You didn't like them, so you made me throw them out.
Buddy. He's just a little man. He's just a little baby, little wooden man. He's just a little wooden baby man. Tell him he's a little baby man.
Hi.
Hi.
I warmed your sheet up for you. Oh, Jesus. Where did it?
Almost went in the Connie.
In the what?
The car, Connie. So I got this. It's a little maggot.
It's fucking Wick Sanchez.
I keep them on my fridge.
I thought you got the other one. I thought you got three.
No, I didn't get a Minecraft one after. I was gonna, but then I was like, they're good.
Fair.
They'll treat me right.
They will.
I'll send you a picture when they're on the fridge.
Okay. A video in horizontal form.
Fuck. Okay.
Okay.
Bye. Say goodbye to the little baby, guys.
Back from the farmer's market. And you'll be proud to know that I did not make Jessica buy me anything. I asked her to buy me stuff, but we didn't get a yes or no, so I didn't make her buy me anything.
Do I have something you own?
I got a lot of compliments on my headband, and the girl that had the cool earrings also runs this heavy metal karaoke at Stanley's Pub once a month. That sounds amazing. And she said it doesn't have to be heavy metal, like she does Miley Cyrus and stuff, so we'll be going to that. Now, we go right back into Gremlin editing mode.
This is the fit for the pink party.
That was so cute and fun. I found my little pal Claire that I used to coach and cheer. So we hung out with each other tonight because we didn't really know anybody else. We took some pictures together. We got to watch everybody dance in the dance circle. Neither of us danced in the dance circle because, you know.
Is he widdly gwiddying right now?
He looked like he was widdly doing a gwiddy. I'm going back to my hotel now because I'm sleepy and I'm old. Bye. I low-key kind of regret going to that party last night. I'm so tired. It's a little bit after 8 in the morning. There's a seminar at 9. I'm probably not gonna make it for that one.
Obviously, I didn't make it to the first seminar, but this is today's fit. Cute.
Breakfast.
My breakfast kind of took a long time, which is weird because it was only avocado toast and a boiled egg. I guess it was the boiled egg. I don't know. Anyways, I have my monster that is the color that I did not want. And oh my god. Please hold. Somebody lost the sunglasses. Sunglasses. Yesterday, I didn't eat breakfast and I literally felt like I was gonna pass out by like lunch. So anyways, had some breakfast and now I walked over and I'm running a little bit late for the next seminar. So I'll see you after.
Hello, my name is Rebecca.
Hi, Rebecca.
I have a pretty good personality. I don't really struggle with like communicating with people or putting myself out there. But something that I do find is a struggle in this industry is having tattoos.
Yes.
I am considered heavily tattooed by some people. I'm just curious, in your experience, is there a place, is there a market for people that are heavily tattooed?
Yeah, tattoos are tricky. So in the more commercial markets, I struggled with it myself in the office in Chicago. Even though I scout for the entire US and I scout for Europe, I work out of Chicago office. So they will say no to someone who's heavily tattooed. But for other markets, just LA and such as New York, not necessarily. And here's what I talk about when the world is changing. Like right now, there are clients and brands who are asking for that, right? Because people want to see themselves represented, right? So representation matters. And so since you already have the tattoos, I don't show up rushing out and try to get them removed. You just have to find the space or the agency that knows that representation matters and will take you on in spite of that, right? Because there are clients that are okay, that aren't even asking, right? They're like, we are looking for the quirky blah, 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 that this. What else do you have going on in your life? Like, what are your hobbies and interests?
I'm a cheerleader for the last 10 years.
So, like, the clients are literally, like, we'll get breakdowns and we'll be like, we want a dancer, we want a creative, we want this, we want that, like, Levi's, right? And so then their tattoos don't matter. So there are spaces where it doesn't matter. That does not mean go out and get a tattoo. If you do not have them, do not get them. If you currently have them, then it's okay because you already did it.
So do you have any suggestions on how to find those types of markets that are looking for that?
I mean, it's going to be probably like in LA or in New York.
Love LA, so thank you.
The sun is finally out and I'm headed back over to the convention. I just hung out in my room for a little bit and made the thumbnail for last week's vlog. And now I'm headed back over for the runway competition. I'm not in it, but I am going to watch because I do know a number of people that are in it. And honestly, I think it'll be really cool to see everybody on the runway, see what kind of outfits people picked out, how good people are. I'm stoked, especially because like the first division is the kids. And I feel like they're just gonna be such superstars. So I'm really stoked to see that. Also, I skipped the cream contour today, but I did tan myself and holy moly, what a difference. I made the right choice.
We've got some runway practice happening.
Supporting dudes.
Tell me, princess, now when did you last?
Bye, girl. So my phone died, but let me recap really quick. I did my TV and film casting competition, and I actually feel really good about it. I think I did all right. Do I think I'll win? Probably not, but that's okay. I feel happy about how I did, and that's all that really matters. I did it. It's the first time I've ever done like any sort of in-person script reading, audition, casting type thing. I've only ever done self-tapes, so cool. Then I watched the swimsuit competition. I ordered some buttered chicken and naan, and I really thought it was gonna come with rice for some reason. Silly me, I guess. Didn't come with rice, so it's just buttered chicken and naan. So that's fine. I still enjoyed it. It's just, it was a little spicy, and usually the rice is helpful for that, but whatever. Didn't eat a whole lot of it because of the fact that it was spicy. So I think I'm gonna run downstairs to the lobby and just see if they have any snick snackities that I might enjoy. Probably do. Good morning, everyone. It's Saturday. Today is my photography go-see. Cutie. So I'm trying to decide what I should wear. I was thinking about wearing jeans, but now that I'm looking and I'm wearing jeans in the pictures, I feel like maybe it's best to not so that they can see something different. I think I'm gonna wear my singlet again. She's cute. What do we think? Is this cute? Should I try to wear it like a different way? Like, is that cuter? I really don't know how to make this happen. Is that weird? I think that's weird. But for right now, I just need to put some makeup on and fix my hair. So, 3, 2, 1. Kept it pretty minimal again today because today is the photo go see, like I said, and I want to try to be as like authentically me as I can. Cutie. I don't know who did the forecast for Toronto this week because they were so wrong. It's beautiful out. It's not warm. Don't get me wrong. Sorry, I really hate birds. Sorry that. Anyways. I need to stop filming from down here because every time I rewatch these clips, I'm like, what are you doing? Nobody wants to see all of your chins. Anyways, I'm walking over to the convention again. The sun is out, it's beautiful. It's a little chilly, but I really don't even care because it's not raining. And that's great. So I'm going over to watch the improv competition. It's already started, but it's on till 10:30 and I think it's 9:30 right now. So I didn't miss a whole lot. After that is when I have to line up for my photography go-see. So, God, the birds are really, sorry. Why am I apologizing to you? I'm so scared of birds. All right, see y'all in there.
You tell me. And, it's closed, but you started with a statement. You're gonna come in. I'm like a jerk at this stage, I'm really sorry. Still in the volcano, questions only.
What are we gonna do?
Don't know.
And, next, come in.
What is this orange stuff?
It's Fire?
Any questions?
Both, everyone questions, everyone. The set is soft.
What? Oh my God.
Why is the set? I don't know, man.
Lord of my friend, I got some beans for you. I heard you like salsa.
Oh my! I mean, what kind of beans got salsa on them?
They're shining.
I'm not trying to get any beans from you.
Just open up.
Why are you looking at me? Oh, whoa.
Just open up. Just take one. Just take one.
I think you want to get up. You can get up. You should go. I think that was good. Yeah. Just.
I even have chili beans.
Really?
When you're alone as a bachelor or bachelorette, sometimes you get lonely, but not with our product.
Okay, I'm done my photography go-see. I felt really good about it, actually. I love to chat. I love to talk to people, so the photography go-see was a good time for me. I just went in and was, like, chatting and having a good time with everybody, so I think that went really well. I came back and just, like, threw on a different shirt because I'm, like, done with everything now. So I'm just going to go back over, and I'm actually going to watch the dance finalists, so... That's where I'm headed now.
To support our talent, let's get things started with, oh, actually, before I get things started, just want to play.
The judges clearly have their work cut out for them with those dance finalists, because every single person that came out, I was like, no, they're gonna win. No, they're gonna win. No, they're gonna win. They're all gonna win. I don't, like, so good. I'm just chilling at the hotel now, again. Are you sick of hearing me say that? But it's like 2:30, almost 3, and the awards isn't until 6:30, so I'm gonna have something to eat, maybe take a nap. Probably not. And then we're gonna go over to awards and the like closing party, dance party, ceremony, celebration thing.
This is my look for awards and the closing celebrations for the weekend. These boots have really come in handy. They go with literally freaking everything. All right, let's go. Wait to take everything that I have on off and lie in that bed. That was a lot of fun, but I'm so done. Okay. Home sweet hotel room.
It sounds like water.
It does.
Yeah.
Guess where we are? Another boring weekend.
Another farmer's market. Who's here today?
Etsy stuff. This is the Etsy, the spring market Etsy.
I feel like I didn't think there was one today at all because I thought I looked online and it didn't say anything. All right, let's go.
You're not going to do a thing?
I'm sorry. Do you not hear me?
I do.
I'm trying to not.
Is it not too close?
Yep.
Oh no. Catnip toys.
You're coming home with me.
The most of the worst they did.
Caitlin scraps. Good morning. It is callback day. And I have 3 callback interviews. So.
Hello, governor.
We're
sitting in the park.
We are sitting in a park indeed.
Do you want to listen to a cool noise?
Show them the noise. Isn't that fun?
No.
Oh, really? You don't think it's fun?
No. We tried to find something to do after the farmer's market and we decided to go for a walk.
Around the town.
Around Bannerman Park, not the town.
Around town.
And now we sit.
Now we sit. You give us ideas on what to do? That's a great idea. Let's go to the mall. First nice day in like 3 weeks.
That's true.
Honest.
Should have brought my camera. We should have went somewhere and took pictures.
Still can. Lost right there.
Yeah, I don't really want to do it. There's a lot of children and babies around in strollers and...
Yeah.
Not in strollers, if you can hear that. I don't want to show this child. There's already way too many children in this video, so
it's concerning.
Yeah. Rebecca's friend Jin won the swimsuit competition though. She was top one.
Which one was hot?
I don't think
was
I...
Was it the girl that she met there?
Yeah.
Oh, like the one who does cheer?
No.
Oh, then I don't know.
No, she made a new friend. Her name is Jin Sexsmith, and she has curly hair.
Yeah. It's a fun name.
There's gotta be something to do, bro. Like...
comfy as fuck.
What are they doing? Are they dancing on this one over there?
Yeah, sure.
High heels. Red dress.
Oh. Red dress!
That stupid fucking show up on one leg.
Hi.
I don't know. But I feel like that man's a secret shopper. I'm sorry, do we look suspicious like we're gonna steal when we have 8 fucking red enough?
Literally.
I guess that
I'm just an indecisive bitch. you wanna give one to him?
No.
Give one to him.
No! Jessica! Stop!
Oh, I did it! I can't believe I shot that through. My car's gonna be shit central.
Stop.
What? The guys?
Everything. You, the guys, the seagulls.
It's like he's got junk in his trunk.
Down in the mood. Austin Powers always defeats me because he has mojo. Mojo, the libido, the life force.
Then lay down. Right, stop stressing yourself out. Oh my god.
Hi, Jax.
You do, Jax. Caitlin, do you see this fucking shit? This is crazy. What is Jax is so weird. I'm just trying to watch my movie. Everyone,
you're dismissed.
Private time. Oh shit, there's a line. Do you think there's any spots? What are you trying to pull right now? Look what he's trying to pull right now. Fuck, he's just
trying to go in a circle, man. What the fuck do you want him to do? Go back down the hill to come back up the hill?
He should have thought of that before.
He's in the parking lot.
Yeah,
because there's no spawn.
Oh, do you think so?
No. Circle in this goddamn parking lot.
You know what though? It looks suspiciously like a roundabout. I don't know. It's still really windy.
Nice. This is Dead Man's Pond.
Whatever.
They would hang people on that hill and roll them down into